Welcome to Public Aprons Cooking School. I'm Chef Willie.
And I'm Chef Kara, and we're here celebrating Hanover Tomato Month.
Join us here every Thursday in July as we prepare recipes featuring Hanover tomatoes.
And you can find these recipes and more in the Hanover Tomato Recipe Booklet at your local Publix.
I'm Chef Willie from Publix Aprons Cooking School, and I'm here to cook a skillet pork tenderloin for you, paired with a Hanover tomato and avocado salad. I am here today with Chris Ray from Center of the Universe Brewing, and he will be pairing a beer for me today to go with this dish.
Well, Chef, thanks for having me. I'm excited. I'm going to go hit the Publix beer cooler and pick something out, and I'll be back in just a few minutes.
Thank you. All right, so you're going to start off by warming up your pan on medium-high. Then you're going to season your pork tenderloin with salt and pepper. You've got about a teaspoon of salt and then a third of a teaspoon of black pepper. You're going to mix that in. All right. And then you're going to add a tablespoon of canola oil to your pan. Let that warm up. Once it starts to get smoking, you can add that pork. You're gonna let the pork sit for at least 3 to 4 minutes just to get brown, all right? And while you're waiting for that to brown, you can come over and cut your tomato, your beautiful Hanover tomato. You're gonna chop it, get rid of the top. You don't want the green. It's a little bit tough. You don't want that to get stuck in your teeth. So you're gonna chop it. Doesn't have to be a nice dice. All you have to do is chop it up because it will break down when you're cooking it. All right. Get some nice even cuts. Don't worry about de-seeding or anything because you want that beautiful juice from this tomato. Go through, rough chop it, and get it ready to go into the pan to cook for your sauce, all right? So while this is still cooking, you don't want to mess around with it. You want to make sure you let it brown. Get that nice Maillard reaction where it's nice and delicious and then it gets crispy. You're going to be locking in a lot of the juices into that pork to make sure it's really tender when you're eating that or when you're getting ready to eat that pork. You want it to be nice and juicy, right? So once this pork is brown, you're going to take it out. You're going to put it in the bowl that you already had it in. You don't have to worry about it being raw. You're going to add it to that bowl, and then you're going to add the pork back to this pot and re-cook it. So you don't have to worry about adding it to the bowl with raw meat in it, all right? And let that keep browning. And then once that's ready, we have a medium onion that was small diced. And then we have a red enchilada sauce. It's a mild sauce. Hopefully it pairs well with the beer that Chris comes back with. Because it's really mild, not too spicy. It's great. So you've got the meat nice and brown. You're going to go ahead and take it out of the skillet. Return the skillet back to the stove. Let that warm back up. And then you're going to add the onions, the tomatoes, chili sauce, and brown sugar, all right? What you're gonna do is cook the onions down. One of the things you'll wanna do is save a little bit of the onion so that you can garnish the taco with it at the end. So you'll save some of that onion, and then you'll save a little bit of this tomato as well. So what we're gonna do is make sure we get this onion nice and brown. Go ahead and let it sit for a minute and then give it a stir. And once they are brown, you're gonna add the brown sugar and the tomatoes. All right, onions are nice and brown and fragrant. Now you can add your brown sugar. Stir that in a little bit. Add your tomatoes, your beautiful Hanover tomatoes that you just chopped up. Stir those in, let that cook down for a minute or two just to break down the tomato. All right. And once that tomato breaks down, you're gonna add the chili sauce. All right. We still have some of the tomato left over. It's for a garnish as well when we build the tacos. All right, so we're gonna add the chili sauce. Let that come to a simmer, and then we're gonna add the pork back to it and cover it with a lid and let it cook for about 15 minutes to 20 minutes, just until the pork is nice and tender and not chewy, because we are putting this in a taco. Once it does come to a simmer, you are gonna cover it and let it cook. So cover, turn it down to a simmer, and let it go for 15 minutes. While your pork is simmering, you can get the other part of the dish ready, and that would be the Hanover tomato and avocado salad. These are diced Hanover tomatoes, and we're also using a canned corn with peppers and poblanos to mix into the salad. We do have some fresh avocados and your tortillas. So tortillas are corn tortillas, or you can use flour tortillas. But for the salad, open up the avocado, take the seed out, and what you're gonna do with the avocado, this is gonna be your bowl. So you're gonna wanna save about a half an inch of the avocado around the sides so it doesn't collapse on you, or you don't lose the avocado that's inside. So you want to make sure you're just digging out a little bit, just like that. All right. So we will save that. Do that with the rest of the avocado so you have it all ready for you. All right, for the avocado and Hanover tomato salad, with the avocado that you took, or the avocado meat that you took out, you're gonna chop it up, and then it's gonna be added to the Hanover tomatoes. So you got Hanover tomato, some cilantro, about 2 tablespoons, just the leaves, not the stems in this part. And that drained corn that you have, add that. All right, and then we're gonna take this avocado, chop it up a little bit. It's another rough chop. It doesn't have to be pretty, because it's gonna go inside and it's gonna be mixed with the all the other ingredients. All right, avocado in there. Stir it in. All And then you're going to take that avocado that you took the meat out of and go ahead and fill it up with that salad that you just made. And these two recipes that we have today are actually separate recipes, so you can make it with another dish, or I figured that this paired well with the pork taco, so it went well, and hopefully Chris does bring back a beautiful beer to go with this, because I'm trusting him. He's going to do well. Love all of his beers from Center of the Universe Brewing. They're delicious. And I know he's going to do us right. All right. So with the pork tenderloin, since it's been cooking for the past 10 to 15 minutes, it should be nice and tender and almost ready to go inside of a taco shell. So you can see that it's nice and tender. Turn it back up again. I have a grill pan set up for the tortillas. The tortillas, you always want to make sure you get a little bit of color onto it. You can put it in a pan, you can put it on a grill. If you have a gas oven or a gas stove, you can put it right on top of that flame and you'll have a nice crispiness to it, and a little bit of char have some more flavor to that taco. All right. And you'll see that all the tomatoes broke down. The Hanover tomatoes are delicious in here. They give it a nice tartness to it, and it cuts through that spice as well. So it's gonna be great. I'm gonna heat up those tortillas. Tortillas. All right. So for the assembly of the taco, you're just pretty much going to put the pork right inside of the shell. And then you remember those onions and tomatoes that I told you to save for garnish. Those are next. So the chopped onions, put them right on top. And the Hanover tomatoes as well, right on top. And then some cilantro to finish it off. All right. And then, just to be extra fancy, we have some crispy tortilla that we can put on top of these avocados for that salad. So you have a little bit of contrast between that softness of the tomato and the softness of the avocado. All right. And that is your pork dish. So now that the dish is ready, I think Chris is on his way back from our beer cooler with that beautiful beer. Oh,
Willie, how you doing?
Doing good.
Oh, I see. I got the beautiful food there. I found the perfect accompanying beer to pair perfectly with it. It's Pocahontas IPA. It's our West Coast IPA, brewed with lots of tropical hops from the Pacific Northwest. And I saw that you made some tacos here. A little bit of heat. Yeah,
a little bit.
Just a little bit. A little bit of avocado, I see, as well, for some sweetness. Well, I wanted to pick a beer, Willie, that went nicely with these, that not only went nice with the flavors, but also added some contrast to it. You know, I don't like to pick out things that match the flavors exactly, because what I like to do is like to have a standalone meal, standalone beer, and then when you combine them together, it creates something unique altogether. So Pocahontas has a nice tad bit of bitterness, which is going to kind of accentuate that spiciness. but it's a West Coast style, so it's got that caramely sweetness that'll really kind of temper it and bring it all together.
Now it's gonna go great with that pork. Good job.
Well, I think the time is now just to get into it.
I think you should open this up and then try it real quick and make sure we did a good job for you.
Well, that looks amazing.
Cheers.
Cheers.